Hey everybody, this is Mike Grozier. In this tip of the week, I want to show you how to add slide numbers to your presentation in PowerPoint so that you don't have to go through and update them one at a time or add them manually by yourself, but so that they update automatically and change no matter what you're doing, whether you add a slide or delete a slide or change the color or formatting, whatever it is, it updates one time automatically for you. If you've seen my previous videos, you know that I love using the Slide Master to do just that, to make one change and have it apply to the whole presentation. That's exactly what we're going to do here. Let me show you first, though, what most of us probably do when we try to insert a page number. So right now, I'm just in my standard view. You can see I'm in normal view. So this is where we work to add information to our slides and to work on them to really turn it into the presentation. If while in this view, I come up and do Insert, and if you can't see what I'm doing on the screen, come on down and open it up to full screen mode or change it to HD if it's fuzzy. But if I do Insert Header and Footer, this is where I have my slide number option. And I can check that and say Apply to All, and it looks like I did just that. You can probably barely see it, but down here there's a number 1, and on slide 2 there's a number 2. The problem is, if I come in and I say, well, let's say we wanted to make this bigger, and so I'm going to change it to Arial Black and size 44 just so you guys can see it. Let's make that a little bigger. You can see I made the change on slide number 1, and while this still says slide number 2, the formatting didn't change. So if this was a 90 slide presentation, I'd have to go through and make that change to every single page number. So that's where Slide Master comes in. Instead, what I'm going to do is I'm going to come up here and go to View, Slide Master. And right now I'm on a layout slide. I can tell that because they're all the same size. So I'm going to come up to the bigger slide, which is the Slide Master, the one that drives the whole presentation. I'm going to click on that. And whenever you come into Slide Master, if it's a new presentation or maybe it's one someone else gave you, a lot of times it looks like the footer information's already set up, but it's not. And the way you can check it to see is if I click here and then I can come up to Insert Header and Footer, but since I'm in Slide Master View, it's going to be a little different. So I do Header and Footer. In this case, it's checked because in the presentation I've actually added a slide number, but you can see, for instance, that date and time is not checked, even though it looks like it's there. It's really not. You noticed that probably on the earlier slides that it wasn't there. So you do need to come in and set up your header and footer each time. But what I'm going to do, I'm going to leave that checked, and I'm going to say Apply to All. And while I'm in Slide Master view, if I make a change, so I'm going to come here to the Home tab, and I'm going to make this really big. I'm going to make it 72 just so you can really see it. I'm going to make that box a little bigger. And let's change the color to bright red just so you can see the difference. And I'm going to make it bold. Okay, so I've made some formatting changes. You can see here on the layout slides that it's starting to reflect that, but I made them on the master slide. And that's important because when I exit out of Slide Master view, the change has applied to every slide in my presentation. And if I add a new slide, you can see that it does it to the new slide as well. They all follow the master slide. Now this one is a little off. You can see it's cutting off the 1. And if you remember from previous Slide Master videos, that's because I made some formatting changes on this slide instead of on the Slide Master. So if I want to get it back to following the Slide Master, I just right click on the slide and say Reset Slide. And now it's in the correct position. It's now following the Slide Master. So what's cool about adding page numbers this way as well is that, let's see, right now I've got 1, 2, 3. If, let's say, I deleted this slide, number 2, it automatically updates, and slide that used to be number 3 is now number 2. So I don't have to worry about going through my presentation and manually changing those every time I add or delete a slide. So that's how we use an insert slide numbers into your presentation, and I highly recommend using Slide Master so that you can just make that change in one place and apply it to your whole presentation. Thanks for watching. Join me next week for the next tip of the week.